We go now to hyperaldosteronism. We say hyperaldosteronism, there is what we call a abnormality or the overproduction of aldosterone in the body. Usually, aldosterone is involved in the reabsorption of sodium and water. Okay? So, aldosterone causes the kidney to reabsorb and water from the urine and excrete. Okay? So, usually, if the renin is secreted based on the RAAS system, by the kidney when there is what we call is low blood volume or low perfusion process, then kidney will secrete renin, and renin will convert your angiotensinogen that is being released by the liver to angiotensin 1, and then your angiotensin 1 is converted to angiotensin 2 by the enzyme known as angiotensin converting enzyme, or the ACE. So ACE converts type 1 to type 2 of angiotensin. Then this angiotensin 2, okay, stimulates the adrenal gland known as to secrete aldosterone. So adrenal gland will secrete aldosterone, and this aldosterone will reabsorb water and sodium from the urine and excrete potassium. So there is what we call a more excretion of potassium and more reabsorption of water and sodium. So on more yung potassium, that will lead to hypokalemia also. This is already related to hypokalemia. Next, so sodium and water retention will increase blood pressure, okay, and aldosterone causes the blood vessels to constrict, that will lead to vasoconstriction and increase blood pressure. So this one, because the contraction, I mean, of the tissues or even the muscles depends also in the sodium intake. So that is why hyperaldosteronism also, okay, involved in the high level of excretion of potassium, that will lead to hypokalemia. Okay, so this is known to be hyperaldosteronism, which involved electrolytes reabsorption and excretion or secretion process. So we go to electrolyte imbalance. So this one, hyponatremia, lower than the normal concentration of sodium in the blood, causes inadequate excretion of water or by excessive circulation of bloodstream. So that is almost less than 135 milli equivalent per liter. So what will happen? Usually, water ingestion, usually this is our blood lumen, there is overhydration or hypervolemia, wherein excess water enters the bloodstream. Okay, so if there is a high hydration process, so water, there is what you call a volume of water also, okay, that is being retained, okay, or fluid retention and euvolemia most common. So water is abnormal retained by the body because of the high level of ingestion of water. Okay, usually that is found in ECF or in the human cell, that is ICF. So number three, so water excretion, so increase yung water excretion mo, volume depletion, hypovolemia least common, sodium along with water is lost from the body with inadequate replacement, meaning more sodium are being excreted because of the volume that is present already in the bloodstream or in the vessel lumen. So there's a tendency, I mean, of the sodium to be excreted out of the body, and there is inadequate replacement of sodium that will lead to hyponatremia. Kung hyponatremia ka, there are a lot of side effects. Okay, so later on we'll discuss what are the side effects of hyponatremia. Syempre, kung taas yung sodium mo, di ba, increases blood pressure. This one, kung low yung sodium mo, that will lead to hypotension or decrease blood flow that is below normal already. Okay, so that is subject for replenishment. So that is considered to be hyponatremia. There is low sodium ion in the blood. Okay, so causes of hyponatremia. So number one, so hyponatremia, we have serum osmolality, okay, or osmolarity, You say osmolality, osmolarity, that is the term used for the balance, or for the what we call this one, the